So I'm going to show you this in 5 minutes, but you should be able to actually do all of this in less than an hour using a modern computer.
Okay,
so I'm going to talk about everything. What is it? How to download, how to install, how to do data display, how to do analysis, how to get data out, and finally a runtime comparison. Sad story. What is PostgreSQL? It is the world's most advanced open source free database, relational database. Runs on all operating systems, has huge capacity. So this is really a good database application in and of itself. But it's got this great spatial extension called PostGIS, which adds a layer onto the database that allows you to do all of the things that you can do kind of common GIS functionality, and has a lot of other advanced features as well. The one difference is that you use SQL, strangely. And so you can have something that you want to select, a couple layers, some relationship between geometries, the geometries themselves, and then some qualifier. So it's a different kind of way of thinking about things. And there's tons and tons of commands. Here's just a smatter, but there's hundreds that allow you to create data, describe data, data analysis, data export, and so forth. Download, simple. Just go to this website, find the link for your operating system, choose your architecture, downloads a big 50 megabyte file, and then you're ready to install. And installation is quite straightforward, so you're just going to follow all the prompts. The only thing that you do need to do is select a super user password, but then basically you can just keep it next, next, next. So it's very easy, easier than on Unix. Installing PostGIS is the layer that's on top of PostgreSQL. And there's a stack builder you just install. You can literally just keep hitting next, and 5 minutes later you will have this software installed. Since it is a client-server software, you have to do a little bit of monkeying with the security settings, but there's tons of examples about this. Usually you want to have the server, which is the client, trust itself. And then running the Postgres is pretty straightforward. There's a graphical user interface. But then if you're Harvey, you would probably want to use the command line interface to PSQL. If you want to create a spatial database, two commands. One is create database. That builds basically the container. And then create extension. That adds in all the PostGIS functionality. And you can do that within the GUI. Let's take a minute or two max. Take PGSQL and OGR to OGR. Here I've got the cities and census units for King County, imported them into the database. And there are a lot of different clients you can use to display PostGIS data. I use OpenJump, which has a lot of advantages that I won't have time to go into, but basically we're looking at the cities and the census units here. I'll give you an example of a simple intersection. So this is SQL on creating a data set from intersection of two different geometries from two different layers. And then I can simply display that in OpenJump. Cool thing is that you can do all this in memory. You don't have to create files. You can test your geoprocessing. You don't have to fill your drive with all of the intermediate files. Here's an example of the same intersection or creating buffers on the fly. Getting data out. There's also these two commands, OGR, OGR, or PG, SQL shape. Here's the results of that, actually, intersection done on the fly, making a shape file, and then that's displayed in ArcGIS. It's also got additional functionality, so there is raster analysis, and then routing. Here's an example of a website that will route you between two points using this as back end. If you like programming, there's a bunch of different languages you can use. Since I've become more accustomed with R, I use R with its connection capability with the database. And here's an example of just showing counts of features. Here's the sad story. I did a comparison on the same virtual machine, it was 2 seconds in ArcGIS versus 4 in 8 versus 50 something. So it doesn't run quite as fast as ArcGIS. And I do like spicy.